I cannot believe you. Tonight here at Centennial Arena, as the Okotoks Oilers are welcoming the Spruce Grove Saints to town. Hello everyone, welcome to the broadcast. My name is Peter Klein, he is Mark French, and you are getting ready to watch again two of the top teams in the league facing off in this matchup here today. And Mark, it is a Spruce Grove team that is, you don't have to look far down the standings to find where they are. They're right at the top of the North. Okotoks looking to get there in the South. It should be a fun one tonight.
This is a big game. It's a big game for Okotoks because they've done so well. Like last night, Drumheller lost to Okotoks. Canmore lost. Black Falls lost. So, you know, the two teams that are ahead of Okotoks lost, and they got 2 points on both of them. If they can sneak this one out, it'll move them up even a little bit higher. It'll actually, I believe, tie Okotoks. They're 2 points behind out of second place.
It does feel like it's going to be that the whole way through now. Like, we're going to be looking, scoreboard watching from here before Remembrance Day on the rest of the way, right?
Yeah, it's a really tight South Division. I mean, if you start going looking at the standings and you do the losses, you know, you don't count Brooks because Brooks is just an anomaly. But, you know, the losses is what you have to look for. And there's only about two or three losses from second place difference from second place to about six. So, yeah, you got to start watching. But Okotoks has really started to come on very well. They're starting to play. They're starting to get healthy again. And, you know, you've got scratches now that are just regular starters. Everything looks good. But this is Spruce Grove.
Yes, so. Spruce Grove, they are off to a great start this year as the top team in the North Division. They had quite the night last night with a few fights toward the end of the game, or what go down in the box score as fights anyway. When you're facing a team that's coming off of what appears to be an intense game like Spruce Grove was a night ago, if you're Okotoks, is there any way you can take advantage of that?
I don't know. I think you realize. Well, I think first you got to realize that last time they came down south, Spruce Grove, they did not do well. On the weekend they lost both games, one to Drumheller, and I can't remember who the other one was. But they allowed 13 goals in those two games. So I think for Spruce Grove, that's what they're really looking for. But you know, for Okotoks, you know, Spruce Grove, they played last night in Canmore. They drove here to Okotoks last night, so they've been here all day. So, you know, this cold, lousy weather isn't really affecting them because they've only, you know, they stayed a block and a half or two blocks away. So that's okay. But, you know, I think that's my biggest concern, is to drive home for you.
Yes. Yeah, that, that was...
It's nasty here.
Yeah, yeah. The blood clot got flowing a little bit early on the drive out here. So maybe a little bit frazzled to start this one today. On the Okotoks side, the last time I was able to call a game with you, the power play was an issue. It seems like they've at least started to get that figured out. Yoder with a couple of power play goals last night. They're starting to move up the rankings in the power play percentage anyway. How important is that to get that special teams going here?
Well, that's huge, because for Okotoks, they don't give up a lot of goals. They have great penalty killing. They don't give up very much. And that, now if you start looking at the stats, they're like second or third in goals for. So they have really moved up. But the power play has to get going, and it has. And I think the big reason is getting Yoder healthy. You know, you needed that. They like to work the high umbrella. And they didn't have anybody with an offside shot on the offside, so nobody could have that one-time shot. And it kind of, they tried to tweak it a little bit, and it just didn't work. And with Yoder back, he got two goals last night again. I think one was on the power play, and they were 2-for-4 in the power play in Drumheller last night. So, you know, for Okotoks, let's hope that power play is back.
Yeah, that would be such a huge help. And speaking of Yoder, talked about that and a few other things with the general manager and head coach of this team, Tyler Dice, when I caught up with him just a few moments ago.
So, Coach, good win last night. How do the boys build off of that going into this game here?
Well, it's just, you know, yeah, the team played well. We were probably one of our more consistent games, and then especially at the on the road and against Drum, which is not always an easy place to play, but just, you know, that consistency part that we're gonna trying to make sure that this team has throughout this year and just get better at it.
Consistency seems to be paying off right now with points in the last 10 games, haven't lost in regulation since the middle of October. Have you noticed a change, or are things just kind of bouncing your way now?
No, it's just, you know, at the end of the day, it's just, it's not about the wins and losses, but just, you know, the individuals and getting the consistency through your individuals game in and game out. And then once you start getting that, then, you know, the results should take care of itself.
One of the individuals who's playing quite well right now would be Yoder. A couple goals last night. He missed a bit of time there last month. How nice is it to have that scoring touch back in the lineup?
Yeah, for sure. You know, like he can put the puck in the net, and you know, he's an older guy that's played a lot of games in junior hockey. So, you know, just having that that experience just helps the team out.
Now, you mentioned last night it's a win against a division rival. Today it's a team from the North Division, although you don't have to look too far down the standings to find where they are. They're first place in the North Division right now. I would imagine facing a first place team kind of helps get the boys going for this one, hey?
Well, I'd imagine, you know, like, you know, they're the team in this league that you kind of want to compete against and try and beat, right? They've always have a good team. They're well coached, and it's always one of those teams that you got to get up for. These games, you know, if you're not up for these games, I don't know what's wrong with you then.
Coach, thank you for this.
Okay, thanks.
It is set to be a pretty fun one today, and we touched on the Yoder return for the team there with Coach Dice. And how big is that to have that scoring punch back in the lineup for this team here?
Oh, it's huge. You miss Coyote. Coyote, you know, you chuckle at him. And don't get me wrong. Like, I mean, during warm-up, these guys usually run a lap or two, and I look at Ty and I go, Ty, you've got the body of a 60-year-old. You know, you can sort of see it. He's not the fittest athlete, but I mean, he's done. He's done his hockey, right? Now he's playing for the love of the game. And to have him back in his lineup, he brings the calmness about him on the ice. You can really see everything sort of, if everything's okay, guys, I'm here kind of an attitude. But he's like a hawk. If you give him that puck, if you give him some space, chances are it's going in the net.
And according to the lines that we got here, he's going to be playing with a new addition to this squad, with Ethan Rowland down the middle coming to the team. The Vernon Vipers, just one game with Okotoks so far. I noticed you start him in the lineups here. What are you looking for from the new center for Okotoks?
Well, this is going to be a tough one. It's tough for me to say, but, you know, here's another kid that's come from the Western League. He's played a few years in the Dub, and he's sort of unwanted, kind of. You know, let's be honest. It happened to me, too. And he went to Vernon trying to find a home, and now I think this is the the sort of a, the deal with last year's player. I'm not going to name his name because I can't even remember Singleton's name. But so we get him now, and it's really important for Ethan to find a home and to fit in. It's going to take him a week or two or three to get going and, you know, maybe feel comfortable here. But I think that's the job of his, and it's the job of his coaches and his teammates to say, hey, you're good enough to play here, and we want you. And he's a goal scorer as well. He's like Ty Yoder, and he's not a little boy, but he can score goals. So I'm going to see this kid, and I'm going to wait. He's got him with Huxley and Yoder right now, which is a big line to just sort of jump into. But it'll take him a week or two to get going. But I think if he can get going and put the puck in the net, this is a huge bonus for the Okotoks Oilers.
And tasked with stopping that tonight, the Spruce Grove Saints, as mentioned before, tops in the North Division. Had a chance to catch up with their assistant coach, Brandon Switzer, a little bit earlier on today to kind of get a lay of the land for what they are expecting for this game today.
You guys are coming off of a pretty hard-fought win yesterday. Got quite emotional toward the back end of that game. How do I guess you either channel that or not let that be a bit of a letdown going into this game tonight?
I think it's just, you know, reset after last night and you know, make sure that the boys are ready to go for, you know, a tough Okotoks team.
Looking at the standings, you guys right at the top of it right now, out north, has to feel pretty good. Obviously still early in the year, but has to feel pretty good to be sitting at the top of the standings.
Yeah, it's great. I think, you know, the North is very good again. And you know, you got Whitecourt and Spruce or Sherrod Park and you know, Bonnyville all chasing. So I think it's just good for us to have everyone on our heels and nipping at us so that we can continue with that.
What has been working for your group so far this year?
Just, you know, we've got a young group. I think it's a learning process every day with them. But they've done a good job at adapting to things and making sure that, you know, they know what's going on at all times. And our leadership group's been great in that aspect.
Down south here against Okotoks, in a bit of a logjam in the south standings. But how important is it for against these teams that maybe you don't see quite as often to kind of set a tone here early on?
Obviously important. You know, you never take Okotoks lightly, right? It's a great program and a great, you know, team that has had great success in the past however many years. So, you know, take it as you come and see what goes on and all that kind of stuff. So we'll be ready.
Thank you for this.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you to Brandon Switzer for doing that. He wanted to be almost anywhere else in the world than doing a pregame interview with me, but he was stuck with it anyway, and we appreciate him for it. But these matchups I always find interesting. You don't play the North Division as much, obviously, as the South. That's just how these leagues work. I always find this type of a matchup interesting. How are you going to be able to attack it? You just focus on what you do. I guess kind of speak to, from a coaching standpoint, how do you go after a team that you don't see as much as your regular coach?
Well, hopefully you've watched a little bit of video. And the deal is the South and the North play two different styles of hockey. You know, the North is typically up and down, a lot tougher, where the South is you have to have speed and quickness. And that's sort of what happens in the South. And for Okotoks, they've this real big homestand that they've had, their forechecking again is their key to their game. They'll try and pin you down there. They'll pressure you at the puck, at the hash mark, at the blue line and the red line, and then the blue line. They'll pressure you all the way down the ice. So if you come out of your zone, if you're Spruce Grove, you've got to come out with numbers. And typically the way that Okotoks does it is there's only one guy left at the end at the red line, and then he ends up dumping it in, and that's their plan. If you're Spruce Grove, I just think, why change what you've... I mean, your record speaks for itself, right? Yeah. And it's... I was looking at that team yesterday and today, and I was going through their stats and all this kind of stuff. It's a heavy rookie-laden team. I mean, they've got 11 rookies in their lineup. They're carrying 22, and they've got 11 vets and 11 rookies. So it's... you wouldn't think that a team like that is going to produce the numbers and what they're doing. So yeah. Kudos to them, but it is Spruce Grove.
Just a couple of quick ones here before the teams come out and we get ready for the anthems. Parker Soccer getting the call in goal tonight. He played last night against Drumheller. I was a little bit surprised to see Soccer get the call in goal, but he has been phenomenal for this Okotoks team to start the year.
He has, and the only, you know, he had a hiccup the last home game here against Lloyd where it was ugly night and he didn't play great, but the funny thing is the other goaltender on the Lloyd side, he didn't play great either. So it was last shot wins. I think there was 20 shots at one point and there was six goals or seven goals. Like it was like, Jesus, 1 for 3 is going into the net. So everybody just start shooting, and that's how the game sort of went. And third period, he closed the door and Lloyd didn't, and Okotoks, they got lucky.
And last one here before the guys come out. This is the second last game before a pretty lengthy road trip coming up here for Okotoks. Kind of adds a bit of urgency to this game tonight, doesn't it?
This one and their next home game is against Black Falls, so that'll be huge. And then they go on the road to Lloydminster, Fort Mac, and Bonnyville 1 weekend. So 3 games in 3 nights. They have a day off, and then they're in Canmore the next day. So they've got 4 games in 5 nights starting November the 11th. That is going to be a challenge for them. And I don't know. That's a tough schedule for anybody to do.
I think that would be tough to broadcast, let alone to actually play the sport of hockey. So it adds quite a bit of importance.
And they're not the nicest rural areas of Alberta
No.
that they're going to. No.
You're not staying at a 5-star hotel in Bonnyville?
I don't think there is one.
I think if you add them all up, you probably get there. So it should be an important one tonight for Okotoks as they take on the top team in the north, the Spruce Grove Saints. The anthems and the puck drop are yours next.
Tonight's Oilers starting lineup is brought to you by Infinite Wealth Management, offering a wealth planning approach to anybody's specialized tax, retirement, and estate planning needs to small business owners. Fans, tonight's national anthem is presented by Quesada Burritos and Tacos at 420 Big Rock Lane here in Okotoks. For those of you who are here, we now ask you to please rise and remove your hats and join Tom Donnelly in the city of Canada. Keep our land glorious.